So we are here with your class, that is chapter number 4, date is 4/11. So subject and predicate, we already got what is subject and what is predicate in our class 3. Yes, I hope you all got this. What is a subject? In a sentence, okay, in a sentence, if the person or thing that performs the action is called the subject. The person who or thing who performs the actions is called the, performs action is called the subject. And predicate, rest of the sentence, like the subject, in rest of the sentence that tells us what the subject is or does. Okay, what the subject is or does, that part is called the predicate. Okay, rest of the part is called the predicate. Like in number one sentence, we will say Ram is a clever boy. Okay, so here, whom we are talking about? We are talking about Ram. That means Ram is the subject. Then predicate, rest of the sentence, is a clever boy, is the predicate. Okay, so in a subject, it may consist of only one word or may consist of a group of words. Okay, it may consist of a group of words also, one word also. Okay, like in page number 10, you see this example, it is given. The subject may consist of only one word or it may consist of a group of words. For example, Jatin bought a pair of jeans. So, Jatin is subject here. Yes, in the second number, a beautiful marble statue stood in the middle of the garden. So, here a beautiful marble statue is the subject and rest of the part is the predicate. Okay, here a group of words is the subject. Yes, so here it is given, read these sentences, tick the person or thing that is doing the action, underline the verbs in each sentences. Lovelin had an apple for breakfast. So you have to tick the person or thing that is doing the action, ate Lovelin. Then number two, the children were flying kites in the park. Flying is the what? Action words. Yes, that is the doing words. And here, children flying. Who is flying? Children are flying the kites. Yes or no? So in number three, Jagriti bought some chocolates for her sister. What did Jagriti do? Jagriti bought. Okay, that is the action word. The kittens threw the ball down the drain. The kittens threw. Okay, this is the action word. Yes, kittens threw. Then number five, John plays the piano in a restaurant. So here, what did John do? Plays. Then number six, they went to the zoo with their children. Who went? They went. Went is the action word here. So you have to do this. Okay, do this in your copy. So I have already given you the answer, so you can do it in your copy. Now write the chapter name, date, write the question and write the everything, question number 1 to 6, in your copy. Okay, every sentence tells us about someone or something and what they are doing or did. Let us learn how we can identify who or what the sentence is about. Read these examples carefully. Latika ate an apple. Latika is what? It is the subject here. Who ate the apple? Latika. Okay? Then, ate is the verb here. Verb, doing words, all of you know, right? Then, Katy writes well. Who writes well? Katy. So, writes is the verb here. Okay. Then, here, the puppy sleeps in the basket. Who sleeps in the basket? The puppy. The puppy is the, what here? Subject. Yes. And verb is sleeps. So in a declarative sentence, the subject comes before the verb. To identify the subject, we ask the question who or what before the verb. So now underline the subject in these sentences. I will give a photo of this. You do this in your copy. Okay, this and this, you do it in your copy. Number here in page number 10 and number A, this question number A, you do in your copy. Thank you and have a nice day.